I know that a lot of y'all are probably wondering why I'm double majoring in marketing and accounting versus accounting and mass communications, what I initially wanted to major in when I got to school. I didn't major in mass comm and accounting initially because those two majors did not correlate at all, and that meant I would have been at school for like 8 years just to get my bachelor's, two bachelor's, you know what I'm saying? That don't even make sense, because in those 8 years, I could have gotten a bachelor's in something, you know, something solid, got a minor, and my master's. But because I'm trying to do what my family want and what I want, I'm gonna be at school that long? Oh no. So marketing and accounting was more feasible and just made more sense because they're both business majors, and a lot of the classes intertwine. And like I said, instead of me graduating with one degree in 4 years, I'm graduating with two. Not a minor, two majors. Do you hear me? So it just made more sense to double major in those two versus mass comm. And mass comm and marketing, you know, a lot of those are similar. Like, it's a lot of mass comm majors who are minoring in marketing. So it's like, I'm kind of getting what I want, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, take it or leave it, whatever the saying is. I'm proud of my decision now, and I'm more content, and I'm not as stressed as I used to be. But that's me talking in the summer versus talking in the school year. Just wanted to clarify.
Questions usually got the answers that I need. Intuition telling me, I just have a good feeling.
What's up, y'all? It's me, Angie B, back again with another video. And today's video is going to be about choosing a major in college. Alright, so I just want y'all to sit here and answer this one question for me. So, if we weren't in quarantine and there was a big event you had to go to tomorrow, right? Could you pick out what you wanted to wear tonight? Okay, the answer to that probably be yes. But the follow-up question would be about how many outfits would you have to go through before you pick the right one for that event? You probably wouldn't even know. I know, like, when me and my friends go to a party or whatever, we done thrown on 8 different outfits just to wear something that's totally plain Jane or something like that, because we're just so indecisive. So my question is, how do colleges and universities and parents and aunties and uncles expect us, at the time we're 18, just graduating high school, how do they expect us to know what we want to do for the rest of our life? Now, you know, as we're kids and we're just always growing up through life, what we want to be when we grow up changes basically every year. One of my friends changed what she wanted to do 3-4 times in our senior year alone. So I asked my brother the other day, I said, what you want to be? An NFL player? Now today he want to be an engineer because he like building houses on Minecraft. Like, your mind changes so quickly and so much as you're a child, and it's like when you're 18, they really expect you to have it all together so you know what you want to do for the rest of your life to learn in college. It's really not adding up. So yes, this video is about choosing a major and how hard that can be and how it's okay to not know what you want to be when you grow up. You know, I initially entered college as an accounting major. But I only did that because, like, you know, you listen to the people who have had a huge impact in your life. So my family was saying, yo, you should do accounting. You can make a lot of money, yada, yada, yada. Of course, we want to make money now. Don't get me wrong. But is that what you really want to do? What's the point of going to a job if you're only focusing on where you're going to vacate? You know what I'm saying? You're only worried about vacation. That means you don't like your day job. So I was like, yo, I don't think I want to do that. But I kept listening to them. So I went all through high school saying I wanted to be an accountant, knowing good and doggone well I did not want to be one. So it's orientation for my first day, well, not my first day in college, but orientation for freshmen for my college, and me and my mom are literally arguing in my advisor's office about how I wanted to change my major to mass communications And she was like, no, you need to stay in accounting. I'm like, I don't want to do accounting. Are you going to be in here these 4 years trying to do my homework? I don't think so. She was like, but they going to make money. I was like, who says I won't make money in the mass communications department? Yada, yada. So we're going back and forth. Like, my advisor remembered me from that day, just from that moment. So, like, literally, I knew I did not want to do accounting because I guess you could say I didn't want to be bored. I have a huge personality and I'm like being stuck inside of a box, I don't know. So that was freshman year. So I endured the first semester of being an accounting major or whatever, but I took accounting one and let me tell you, I was like, I need to change my major. So I changed it to marketing. Marketing seemed like it was more my speed. It's still in the business field. But it involved more creativity versus just analytics, and I like to use my creative side. Although I have, you know, some smarticles up here, I want to use my creative side. I want to be able to have fun while I'm on the job and not always be looking at a spreadsheet, you know what I'm saying? So I changed my major to marketing second semester of my freshman year, whatever. So I didn't really technically start my major courses. So sophomore mixed with junior year, whatever, I started my marketing courses, but my journey with trying to get an internship was not successful at all, because I came to college with a lot of college credits. I entered college as a sophomore, actually, so it made me have to speed up my process, and I was like, dang, I'm graduating earlier than most people my age, so I gotta find some, you know, opportunities for experience. Couldn't find any, so I was like, you know what, I think I'm a double major to make, I'll stay here the four years or whatever, and I'm just going to make myself marketable. Now see, I'm now double majoring in marketing and accounting. Yes, accounting, what me and my mom was fussing about in the advisor's office, what I said I did not want to do. But see, it's a difference when someone forces you to do something and you make that decision for yourself. At first it felt like it was forced, and I'm not going to say that I am, what's the word, where you're going against people giving you advice, something with a D, I can't think. I'm not going to say that I am defiant, but I needed to do that for myself because this is essentially my life. So yes, I am now double majoring in the major that I said I did not want to do, but I'm trying to make myself marketable. But that took time and self-evaluation and self-reflection of what I could see myself doing and what I wanted to, you know, accomplish in life and whatnot. So that didn't come from when I was 18. I made that decision when I was 20 to double major, because I just felt like it was a better situation. It would put me in a better situation. Of course, that's what my family said, but I had to see it for myself. And a lot of us are doing things or are in majors because our parents told us to do this versus that's what you really wanted to do. I really commend the parents that let their kids go through the majors or whatever, but for the parents that care, I understand where you're coming from, but you got to realize that your kids have to make that decision for themselves because that is their life that they're going to be living, not yours. You did what you wanted to do. Nobody told you to be a teacher if you didn't want to be one, right? You became a teacher because you wanted to be one. But yes, I don't understand how when you go to college, they really expect you to know what you want to be. That really takes time. Like, those little tests that you take that tell you what you should be when you grow up or whatever, I don't think they're too accurate. But I mean, because they told me I wanted to be a teacher, I was like, my patience level with children, it's okay. But when it comes to learning, like, I was such a perfectionist when it came to learning in school. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna be yelling at them kids if they can't get that 2 + 2 = 4. But yeah, this was a quick video, and it was more like a rant of how I undid what my mom and my family told me to do and ended up doing it again. So it's like I'm actually getting what they want and what I want at the same time. You get the best of both worlds. Chill it out, take a step. just to clarify, I don't have plans to actually go into the accounting field. I just want to make myself more marketable to get a job, because when you have an accounting degree on your back, man, that just makes you sound like you're top tier. So yes, it's time for the Ange word of the day. I really talk fast. I just wanted to get it over with. The Ange word of the day is to know that it's okay to not know what you want to do when you grow up. Like, it really matters now what you want to do. So if you went into college as a straight up freshman, like you didn't have credits already on your back, you're not so much in a rush as I was, because like I said, I came in as a sophomore, so my major courses were going to start the next year. So I was like, I got to get it out of the way. Versus if you're for real freshman, you have prerequisites, you have time on your hand, not too much time, but you have time to get to see what you would really like to do. This decision is impactful, but I'm going to say that a lot of people told me that what they majored in is what they didn't even end up doing when they got into the workforce. So, you know, it is what it is. This is where you're going to be spending your money. This is what you potentially plan to do for the rest of your life. So think really hard on it. Self-evaluate yourself. See, is this what I'm going to go to and be happy for at least 20 years? You know, but I encourage everyone to get that degree and to go to college and, you know, just take everybody's opinion, but make sure that yours is on the top, because it's your life. You are the pilot of your life. Don't let anybody else try to drive. They in the passenger seat, in the back seat. You are in the driver's seat. It's your life. Figure it out for yourself, and it's okay if you don't know as you're entering college. It's okay if you're in college and you still don't know, but by the time you hit that junior year, you're going to be wasting money if you're switching your major your junior year, because you're going to have to pay for more classes, especially if the majors do not connect. So I encourage all to make your major decision before that third year of college, aka your junior year, because that's when you start your major courses. This was a fast video of Angie B TV. Sometimes I get in a little mode where I just gotta talk. But I hope you took something from this. I hope parents took something from this when you're looking at your kids and going to college. Like, let them figure it out on their own. Of course, guide them, but don't try to run them. And if you're a kid, or not a kid, but a student entering college, or you're just a little kid, it's okay to change your mind every 2 seconds. It's really okay. I still know what I want to be. I'm not even in the major that I really want to be when I grow up, but I have plans to network and market myself to get to that place that I want to be. So without further ado, I just want to tell you guys, thanks for watching this video. Like down below, subscribe down below, turn on your notification bar. And I just want y'all to wear your mask, be safe, be blessed, stay happy. Do all of those things and more. And we'll see y'all next week on NGP TV. Bye.